Welcome to another array live coding or demo of the coding. In this particular problem, what I'm trying to do here is I'm interested to find the second largest of a series of numbers entered into an array. So the function I have defined first is readArray, which is used to read a series of numbers into an array. Then I'm going to write my own function called as second largest underscore array, which is going to help me find the second largest of a series of number which the user has entered. Now I have defined the maximum size of the array elements as 50. That's why I have declared array int a of max. Although the size is 50, the user may not be interested to enter all the 50 numbers. He or she may just enter a few numbers they are interested in. So I'm going to ask the user enter how many numbers he or she wishes to enter. Using scanf, I am going to read the how many numbers user wants to enter. N can be 5, 10, 15, but it should be less than 50. Then using this readArray function, I am passing the name of the array as well as the limit of how many numbers the user wants to read into this function called as readArray. The reason x is star is, or a pointer type of variable is, because in C, when array is passed to a function, in place of A, the address of the array is passed. That's why x contains the address of A as shown here. Now, n gives me the endpoint. So using the for loop, I am going to read all the numbers starting from 0 to n. Now I am going to write my own function called as second largest, where I am passing the name of the array or the address and the total number of elements. In order to simplify the coding, what I am going to do here is I am going to define the first variable called as large, and I am going to define one more variable called as second large. To start with, I am going to start processing only the 0th and the first location. So I am going to say if x of 0 is greater than x of 1, alright? If x of 0 is greater than x of 1, it means the largest happens to be x of 0. And automatically the second large is going to be x of 1. Now there is another option possible also. The other option is x of 1 is greater than x of 0. In that case, what I am going to do here is I am going to say x of 1 is the larger number and second large happens to be x of 0. Alright. So since I have defined this if and else statement, it's important that I put in brackets so that this complete two statements get associated with the if, and these two statements get associated with the else. Let me put a semicolon and flower bracket. Due to space restriction on the screen, I have put the flower bracket on the same line, but generally you do not do this. Put it on the separate line so it's a lot more clearly. So it's a visible a lot more clear. Maybe I should do that, not a problem, because this, okay, so this is how you should really be doing it, so that its code tends to be clear and visible rather than crumpled and all at one place. So this way it looks nicer, cleaner and easier to debug when you get runtime or compile time errors. So this way what I have done is I have initially, using element 0 and 1, I have found out the largest and second largest. Now it is very easy. What I am going to do here is using a for loop starting from the second location. As long as the value of I is less than n, I am going to check for each number. First thing what I am going to do here is I am going to say if x of I is greater than large, that means the current number is bigger than large, then what I am going to do here is I will make the second large equal to the old value of large, and I will make large equal to the new value of x of I. Alright, so this takes care of the condition when the current number is bigger than large. I replace second large with large and I replace large with x of I. There is still one more possibility. The other possibility is if x of I happens to be just only bigger than second large, that means it is not bigger than large, I only need to replace the second large. So here what I'm going to do here is I'm going to say second large is x of I. Alright, so this should end my for loop. Once I end my for loop, I am ready to do the printing of the statement where I am going to say printf second largest number is percentage d slash n, and I am going to say yes large. So this should print my second largest number of a series of number I have asked and entered from the user. Now what we can do is let's expand this code and copy this code onto our favorite online GDB compiler to see if it is compiling, and then we can test it out for the correct results. So what I am doing here is I am going to paste it here. Let me try running this particular piece of code. Okay, there is some error. I have forgotten, I should say int I. Okay, so now if I try to compile, I think we should be okay. Let's say I want to enter 7 numbers into an array. Then what I can do is I can enter 0, minus 1, then I can enter 9, then let me enter 88, let me enter 3, 4 and say minus 88. I hope I have entered, yeah, this looks like 7 numbers. Let's see which is the second largest. So without even running, the second largest should be 9. So it is clearly shown that the second largest number happens to be 9. So if you look at this piece of code here, it is quite clear that first I am asking the user to enter the number of numbers. I am asking the user to enter 7 numbers into the array. And based on the logic here, okay, I am initially finding out between 0 and 1 which is large and second large. And in the loop, I am trying to check if this new value is bigger than large, as in this case, then I am replacing second large with large. So in this case, second large is going to become 0 and large is going to become 9. This process keeps continuing till I find the correct second largest number, and then we can halt. So I hope this program is clear to you. As usual, take a look at the description section for the link of this particular program so you can download it, play around with it and develop your understanding further. The reason you have star where array is received is because in C, arrays are always passed by address.